a clarification from the Philippine Health Department. It says no province or city has been escalated to alert level 2 from alert level 1 since January. Now, it asserts the alert level status of 26 areas mentioned in a recently issued interagency task force resolution have already been under alert level 2 since June of last year. These areas include Benguet, Tugao, Quezon Province, Palawan, and Camarines Norte. The El Nino phenomenon may already take place by May this year. State Weather Bureau PAGASA announced there is a 70% chance that Filipinos will experience it by next month. The National Water Resources Board, meanwhile, gives its assurance that Angat Dam, which is one of the main sources of water in Metro Manila, is still at an operating level. According to the United Nations, temperatures globally continue to rise, recording the warmest weather from 2015 to 2022. Back in the late 90s, the Philippines experienced one of the worst effects of El Nino, with the country's agriculture losing almost 8 billion pesos.
The hot temperatures forced some schools in the Philippines to suspend in-person classes. This amid reports students are getting ill because of the intense heat. DepEd spokesperson Michael Poa said they're giving the school heads the authority to decide whether or not to hold face-to-face classes.
Puro kahit saan po sa Pilipinas, basta po sa ating mga public schools, ang ating mga school heads ay meron pong discretion at authority na magsuspindi ng in-person classes at lumipat sa tinatawag nating alternative delivery modes kung sakaling napakainit po sa ating mga paaralan dahil ayaw naman nating makaapekto sa kalusugan ng mga bata at pati na rin ng ating mga teaching and non-teaching personnel yung init ng panahon.
Meanwhile, the Teachers Dignity Coalition calls on the Education Department to shorten class hours and suspend the use of school uniforms due to the hot weather. The fuel price rollback expected to take effect this week. Gasoline prices are expected to take the biggest cut by up to 1 peso and 80 centavos per liter. Meanwhile, diesel prices may drop by as much as a peso per liter. Kerosene will take the smallest cut by up to 40 centavos per liter. This comes after back-to-back oil price hikes the past weeks.
Food businesses in the Philippines feeling the pinch of high rice prices. Now, this includes some eateries which already scrapped their only rice promos after the staple foods price increase. Agriculture group Sinag attributed this to the high cost of the farm gate price of rice. The group adds it may take 3 months before the price cools down, but it says the 50% cut in the cost of fertilizers can help address the rice problem. According to Sinag, a kilo of well-milled rice now costs nearly 40 pesos.
Scientists at the International Rice Research Institute are developing varieties of climate-resistant rice, hoping to curb the effects of climate change on agriculture. More in this report.
This variety of rice is climate resistant and climate smart, designed to withstand droughts, floods, and rising sea levels. Scientists at the International Rice Research Institute are testing the experimental plant in these flooded rice paddies in the Philippines. They hope a crop that could withstand the impact of extreme weather will help curb the effects of climate change on agriculture. In Los Banos, south of capital Manila, farmers are planting experimental flood-resistant rice. Scientists say it can survive being submerged in water for up to 2 weeks longer than regular rice. Shalab Dixit is a senior scientist and plant breeder at the IRRI.
With climate change, with increased abiotic and biotic stresses, with a reduced amount of water available. We need better genetics for rice to be able to provide stable yields in fluctuating environments.
In addition to flood-resistant rice, the team is currently also focused on developing drought-resistant and saline-resistant varieties. Using an advanced breeding method known as marker-assisted breeding, scientists are able to detect genes of desirable traits from rice grains and combine them into other rice varieties to produce a more favorable crop. Rulix Mendoza is a research manager at the institute.
So the donor parent is the one donating the trait, say drought tolerant, submergence tolerant, all those things. And that the recipient parent, this is the one receiving that trait to add to the positive traits that it currently has. Say, for example, this recipient parent, it is very high yielding, early maturing, so good eating quality. So you need to put in those traits, those drought tolerance, submergence tolerance, or cold tolerance to produce offspring having all those traits.
The drought-resistant variety carries genes that enable rice crops to survive weeks longer than regular crops and continue to grow with very minimal water. It's now being planted by farmers in India, Nepal and the Philippines. Alex Abortes, a farmer in the northern province of Bulacan, known for its droughts, says the climate-resistant rice will definitely improve yields for him.
It's good that even if there is no water, there can still be hope, even if there's just a little moisture for the rice to survive. It's difficult sometimes as we can't always plant on certain parts of our farm when there's no water.
The Southeast Asian rice-producing country is usually hit by an average of 20 tropical storms every year. In 2022, a total of 37.6 million Philippine pesos, more than $670,000 worth of agricultural damages, were caused by floods. That's according to the Philippine Department of Agriculture. And over $450,000 of those damages were rice crops.
What we hope is that, you know, these varieties will lead to improved stability and reduced risk in rice cultivation, so the farmers can earn better and have less cost of production, which will eventually lead to their income and other aspects, improvement of other aspects as well in their lives.